Hey guys, I'm Eric with Extreme Terrain. Today we're checking out this OPR front bumper cover with fog light openings fitting all 2007 to 2018 JK Jeep Wranglers. You should pretty much be checking this out if you are looking for a more affordable option to replace the factory front bumper cover for your JK Wrangler. Now, there could be any number of reasons why you're looking to replace the front bumper cover on your JK Wrangler. Maybe your existing front bumper cover has helped you forge your way down some extreme trails over the years. Maybe you went camping and a wild honey badger decided to use it for a chew toy. Or maybe you loaned out your Jeep to your teenage kid and now it has some parking lot rash on the front end. Or most likely, maybe just after some years of aging, weathering, and some sun exposure, it's just starting to look pretty faded, tired, and old. Either way, it's time to replace the front bumper cover. This OE grade replacement from OPR is really an excellent option to replace your factory front bumper cover. Regardless of the reason you're doing it, it's going to be a more affordable option as opposed to some other options out there, maybe taking it back to your dealership and having them order you a new one. This is really quite a simple installation, as you'll see here in a minute. There's no reason why you shouldn't buy this yourself and get it mounted on. Now, as far as price goes, this is currently priced around $225. That's a pretty affordable option, especially if you consider what you might get charged at a dealership. And as far as the installation goes, I'm giving it a very basic 1 out of 3 wrenches on our difficulty meter. Some basic common hand tools are all you're going to need to get this job done in about 30 minutes or less. Let's go ahead, take a look at the tools we're going to use, and get this thing mounted on. Okay guys, the tools I'm using for this install are an electric impact wrench, a socket wrench, an extension, 14 and 18 millimeter sockets, and a power drill with a Phillips head attachment. All right, now guys, the first steps to this is we're gonna remove our factory bumper altogether. Now, in order to do that, there are 4 bolts here and 4 bolts on the other side that attach the whole bumper assembly to the frame, and those are 18 millimeter bolts. Your Jeep, you might also have to disconnect the wiring harness from the bumper, popping out some pop clips. Ours isn't quite set up that way, so I can't really show you how to do that, but it's pretty straightforward. Either use a trim removal tool or a wide blade flathead screwdriver and just pop those clips out where the wiring is attached to the bumper. You might also have a couple of splash guards in here. As you can see, we do not as well on that, so I can't really show you that. But otherwise, it's pretty straightforward. We're gonna remove this off, do some table work, switch over our fog lights, and install the new bumper cover on this bumper. So let's go ahead and get started. All right guys, what we're looking at here are these 2 nuts that are on the bolt studs. You're gonna need an 18 mil socket for those. I'm gonna leave this one on a couple of threads just to make sure the bumper doesn't fall off on us as we undo the rest of the bolts. All right, now we're gonna move to the inside of the frame rail. All right, now to get at this one, guys, it's a little tight in here with all the mechanicals and equipment we have mounted on the Jeep. I'm gonna use a 6-inch extension and 18 mil socket. Getting at it from down below, you should have no problem. It's just a little bit tight. All right guys, now the 4th bolt, which is basically on the inside of the frame rail on the top, you should be able to get at from standing above if you've already removed the splash guard or if you don't have a splash guard up top here. I'm just gonna grab a shorter extension along with our 18 mil socket to get at it. All right, now we're gonna do the passenger side. Okay guys, after you get the 4 nuts off of the passenger side frame rail, you should be able to pull your bumper out. I already took the one that I had finger tight over here on the driver's side. And disconnect your fog lights. And take your bumper away. All right guys, now I have our factory bumper up here on the table. We're gonna do a couple of quick things here to transfer over our fog lights and get this old tire bumper cover off so we can put the new one on the metal frame. There's gonna be two bolts on this side and two bolts on this side. We're gonna undo. We're gonna use a 14 millimeter socket to get that done. Now with those four bolts removed, you should be able to just pop up the metal frame and remove it. All right, once you have the metal frame out, go ahead and pop out your tow hooks. All right guys, now we're gonna remove our fog light housings, and obviously we're gonna use a Phillips head screwdriver for these. Your Jeep may be equipped with four Phillips head screws for each fog light housing, but ours is a special edition and only has three. All right guys, real quick, now that we have our factory bumper disassembled, and I wanted to put it up here next to our new cover and just kind of show you guys the difference. Obviously, they're identical, except the one we took off our Jeep's been used, abused, and ridden pretty hard. It's all weathered, faded, and scratched up. If your Jeep is an older JK and you've done a lot of trail riding, it's probably gonna look a lot worse than ours, even though ours is looking pretty bad itself. This is gonna be an upgrade in appearance for your Jeep. It's really gonna do a lot to clean up the front end. So obviously, that's what you're going for with this new replacement. So let's go ahead and get it mounted up. All right, now to mount our fog light on the new cover, there are these little starter holes in here that will just line up with your Phillips head screws. Now these screws should be the self-tapping kind, so you should be able to just drill them in to the plastic. And go ahead and repeat that on the other side. All right, go ahead and set in your tow hooks. All right guys, now go ahead and grab your metal frame. We're gonna set it back in place. All right guys, now we're gonna reuse our factory hardware, so go ahead and grab these bolts with washer. And then go ahead and tighten them down using a 14 mil socket. All right, now with everything assembled, we're going to go ahead and reattach it to the Jeep. All right, we're going to plug in our fog lights. All right, guys, now we're going to reinstall the factory nuts here. And go ahead and use an 18 mil socket to tighten them down. Then go ahead and repeat that for the inside of the frame rail. All right, guys, go ahead and replace the four nuts on the driver's side as well. All right, guys, that wraps up this review and install of this OPR front bumper cover with fog light openings fitting all 2007 to 2018 JK Jeep Wranglers. And of course, for all things Wrangler, keep it right here at extremeterrain.com.